Hey guys, I hope that you're doing well. It's a bit cold down here, so I'm still doing the whole Defies Brotherhood look. So, last time we did this drawing where it was meant to be the Tiberian sun rising over the landscape. There's different colours of the sky up there, and this bottom layer was meant to be greenish, sort of orangey, because it was filled with Tiberium radiation. Didn't exactly come out how I wanted it to look, but it sort of got a different effect. It does look good because, well, look alright because this bomb layer that was meant to look like the sky, or be a part of the sky, sort of looks like the sun nestled in a mountain range, which is, which I think is a much better look than, what I was going for. There's a nice lady, Cole C, I think. He left a message on last video, with a tip, about how to draw, or I should draw things in the background first, and then draw forwards. And I thought that was a really good tip, so I'll try doing that this time. So I've got my colours off to the side here, I've got my paintbrushes, and we've got this up here. So we're going to try and do the sun first and then work forwards. So, I'll use a little marker just to draw, so I've got an idea of where I want things to be, because I've heard that's a thing that professionals do. Okay, and then those will be cut off, because that will be covered up by a mountain, yes. Should it be two mountains? Yes, okay. That looks good. Now we'll do this just off to the side. Okay. So our first brush will be yellow. We'll paint in the sun. Terribly sorry if you can hear some noise. It's a bit windy outside. And I just realized I've made a mistake. I've made a mistake already. That black is far lighter than the yellow. But it's like that. I'll find a way to cover it. Should probably could just color in high sun, because the brown will go over the top anyways, right? Yeah. I'm doing a mountain range because I want this to look like a sunrise or a sunset. And seeing the sunrise or sunset over a mountain range, I think it's very pretty. It's one of the things I really like. Actually, the afternoon is one of the things I like, you know, where it's just typical afternoon, everything's sort of amber coloured. It reminds me of one of my favourite songs, The Wrong Way Kids. I always imagine that taking place in the afternoon. or starting off in the afternoon. So I think it looks alright. So we'll start doing the outline of the mountain range. One of my fonder memories of high school, I guess it's not exactly a memory, more just a place, a moment in time, was I would have chemistry or biology, I think chemistry and biology, as my final class on different days. So I'd have multiple days of being in the science building. Science building was the tallest building in the school. Used to stick out a lot over everything else. And you could look out the windows, you could see all the way to this really far mountain range. And I always thought it was really nice. You could look over the suburb, and you could look over the main bit of town. I always thought it was super nice. So, I didn't wash these paintbrushes very well, so I'm going to paint them really quickly. I'll wash them really quickly and then we'll get back to this. Okay, and we're back. Brush is a bit more malleable now, so hopefully, oh yeah, okay, yep, this is going a lot better. Alright. It might be a bit wet, looks like a bit of water is going in. That's alright. I used to love high school. It wasn't an enjoyable experience. In terms of socially. But what really made it memorable was the teachers, and the classes, and the sense of consistency. I need a bit more brown. Some of the teachers that I had, absolute dicks. Some of the worst people I've met. But some of them were absolutely fantastic. There was Dr. Tonks, Dr. Darnell, Miss Grant. She's probably a doctor by now. Who else is there? Okay, I guess it was just the science teachers that inspired me. But yeah, they inspired me a lot. Now I did a fair few of the sciences. Well, I did chemistry and biology, because those are what interested me. And actually, since I was very, very, very young, I'd always wanted to be a geologist or a paleontologist. I always made that little distinction. And that's what I wanted to be. So in high school, I made sure I had the right stuff for it. And yeah, I planned it out very well. But then, around the end of grade 11, I had a bit of a change. I didn't really want to get into science anymore. I wanted to do teaching, and it seemed like a nice thing to do. So that's what I did. I changed my thing in grade 11, so pretty sure I kept all the same classes. And in grade 12, it was just working towards teaching. And then I graduated. I think I got B's and C's, 1A I think, but I got mostly B's and C's. And we had this big test that was every school had to do it, because we are under a system called the OP system. OP. I think it was overall placement or something. I've no idea. They've gotten rid of it as well, 1A, because it's really dumb. But anyways, basically sums up your grades, and then also the results of a QCS test. But from the QCS test, it averages, well, it doesn't average, but I think it grades on a curve, so it can drag people down, and I got a really good score on the QCS. I think I got a B, and so I was looking at OP 14, I think, and then the bell curve kicked in and dragged me way down to, well, not way down, I think it dragged me down to 16 or 17, which is a little bit too low for the university I wanted to go to, but that's okay. I ended up going to this other one. That was really, really, really nice. It was also close enough for me to actually go to, so that was a big bonus. So I got into teaching, and I started doing history and an English, a Bachelor of Education, Bachelor of Secondary Education, majoring in English and History. It was actually really good. I enjoyed it a lot. I got better grades at university than I did in high school. That's amazing. But there were a few big incidents for me around that time, and it really sapped my drive. So I'm still enrolled in it. I can go back whenever I want, but I just have trouble going, because I'm a bit afraid. But I know that when I'm ready, I'll go back there. I'll finish my degree. It'll be fantastic. And it was actually just how my teachers that inspired me to want to do teaching. And I mean, I do enjoy it a lot. I've been looking at, there are very few jobs where I am, so I was actually looking at doing tutoring, and hopefully I can find somewhere soon. But one video that I really want to do is, like a history teacher roleplay, you know, where I just go over different things in history and present it as a video. I mean, so many people fell asleep in history class. It's got to be good for ASMR, right? Just need a bit more brown, and we're almost done with this bit. Okay, that's good. Enough. That doesn't work, I'm wearing a mask. Okay, so now, get our next brush, and we will paint the sky. So I'm just going to do a light blue. Maybe we should draw some nice little clouds in the sky. I like clouds. Bit more light blue. I probably should just like do a big bit of blue, but big bit of different colours I need, but I don't like to make that sort of dedication to using it all. I think I see what Cole was meaning about painting layers, because now I've got to carefully paint around the sun. But, well, I mean, I did try to do it, how you told me to do it, Cole, thank you for that. But I see now that I should have done the sky first, totally. And then, back forwards to the sun, but I was starting off with the sun as my furthest thing. Technically, it is the furthest thing, so I've got you there. But yeah, it's all good. We just paint around. I can paint close to sun. Crap! Oh my god! I've just ruined it. I can paint around the sun and then go from the sun over everything else. That would work. I after filming the last video, I didn't empty the camera. it's memory. So we're working bit of a time limit here. And we're closely approaching it. We've got 6 more minutes. I'll have to end it. Alright. End at 25 minutes, and then quickly go through, delete some excess footage, and then pick right up where we left off. I've just got to make sure I pay attention to when it fills up. Okay, we'll get our yellow out, and we'll fill out the sun. See, this is another brush I forgot to clean. Okay, I made a mess of it. But that's okay. I want to wait for it to dry a bit, and then I want to draw some plants on this little mountain. Okay, so I went through, deleted some stuff, should be good now. So, this is dried slightly. I should wait for a bit longer. I had that kind of guy. So we'll just put my drawing on it. Brown, it's more of an orange. It looked brown on the little bottle. So we'll go. That's far too much. We'll draw it over here. Yeah, okay, that's not brown. Whoops. And my green is now blue. That's my lightest blue. You know what I should have done? I should have spread that one, like, I should have spread the blue extremely thinly, I think. Because I coated it off to make sure it was a good coat, and now it's a bit too dark. But we all got to learn. Loud car in the background. Okay. Ooh, my yellow is giving bubbles. Wonder if it's punctured somewhere. Okay. This is way too much yellow. Oh well. Silly way to do it. I like that. I might get a different brush. We'll draw some bigger plants. Okay, this one's not at all bigger, but it has different bristles. Okay, I guess it is bigger. See this? I'm not sure if you can see it from back there. There's this little bit right there. So it looks like a bit of a rock slide, because it's, or a mud slide, because it's not melting. That's a little bit of green that's going down there. Exactly what I wanted to look like. But I think it turned out right. I know what it needs.
Nice little bit of green just down there in the corner. Yes. There's a bit of empty space there. Could use some. Alright, you know what we forgot? We need to put in a cloud. Alright. Let's get out our cloud. Something turned a bit blue. Maybe it's a mirage. That's what I should have done. I should have mixed the white and the blue together. It's a very thin cloud, yes. Alright, well, thanks for joining me for drawing my painting. I hope that you enjoyed it, and I hope that you have a really nice night. So, sleep well, please. Bye.